This is Cooking with Larry's Larry Izzo.
Read your
apron. Laughs with Larry, Cooking with Comics.
This is Laughs with Larry, Cooking with Comics, and he's going to open the show with a song that was written about a blind Spaniard that just had an operation. This is called Jose, Can You See?
I'd like to dedicate this show to all the first responders and every man and woman that ever wore a uniform and defended this beautiful country.
Yeah.
Woo! As a Cub Scout, I accept.
So, hey guys, thanks for tuning in and welcome to Laughs with Larry's Cooking with Comics. Woo!
Born, the nurses all gathered round. They gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad, bad to the bone.
All right, brother.
I am great. Sounds like somebody's at the door. Who is this fella?
How are you?
It's Bianca, the filmmaker.
Hi, Bianca.
How are you?
Pleasure.
You?
Welcome to Made a Mistake, the first annual Long Island Steak Cook-Off. I'm about to give Larry the receipt for the money he spent unknowingly for the corn, 3 pounds of shrimp, all the accoutrements. You owe me $130. You can pay me in cash or else you can go home.
Okay, I'll pay you in cash because I'm out of gas.
Let's count it. We got it. All right, now we can proceed. All shrimp is frozen. If you buy fresh shrimp at a seafood place, it's shrimp that was frozen and they defrosted it. So you're paying money for them to defrost it. So we bought cooked shrimp that was frozen. This is great shrimp. Now it's defrosted and I'm going to put it in the refrigerator so it'll be nice and cold for us.
Charcoal.
Yeah. This is so you don't have to use
fire starter.
Oh, I
or have a 30-foot extension cord for one of those things.
Right. So let me ask you though, is this something that you made or
is this
pre-made?
When I moved in here, Dwayne across the street does this with a number 10 tomato can. I said, "What's wrong with you?" Then somebody else showed me that they actually sell these things.
I'm a 10 tomato can.
And I always melted a few. Why they insist, the last one I had wood there, and now this is plastic, which is crazy. It didn't melt yet, but it will. I cook with the barbecue, which is way too hot, but I like steak
hot.
A little black on the outside and very rare. I had a girlfriend in Detroit whose father was so cheap. And he had a Weber, but this one, yep. And he used just enough charcoal, one coal deep, and he'd sit in his plastic broken down lawn chair. And I'd sit in the broken down lawn chair next to him, and he'd say, "I wonder what the poor people are doing." Which people have said for years and years, but it was just perfect. Oh, yeah. We'll go marinate your steaks next, right?
Okay.
We're gonna try.
Looking nice. Wow. Beautiful, man.
So here we have two marinated flank steaks,
marinated in yari teriyaki sauce.
Sold in every supermarket, by the way. It's no big deal. I have made this steak for people, and I never told them what the sauce was, and they keep begging me. And finally, I broke down and gave it to them. And now all they cook is this steak marinated in this sauce. I think they're definitely going to win the cook-off over that bland piece of meat over there.
Oh yeah.
I have this set for 15 minutes aside.
Uh-huh.
And it's such a hot fire that who knows what's going to happen. But I'm going to let it do a full 15, and I'm going to flip it over and check it every few minutes.
And then you got another 15 minutes on the other side?
No, probably not. So when I flip it, that's when you get to work.
Okay.
You want this hotter?
No, this is good. It's on medium, right?
It's on... This is medium.
Okay, yeah, we'll keep it on medium. So as I was in the pest control business, I used to service a lot of places in the meat market, and they used to take these large slabs of meat, throw them down the filthiest chute that you ever saw, drag them through the street. It was the most amazing thing, and I'm wondering how the hell anybody eats this stuff. And then you got rats eating them down there, standing on
it. The guitar player in my band in Decatur, Michigan, his father was a meat inspector, and the rest of the band lived with the drummer's house, and they all went with his father to inspect the meat. None of them ate meat for another 10 years. It was so...
Have no idea. Oh, you God. Have no idea what goes on in meat plants. Now they have...
That's 15 minutes.
Okay, right. You're making the flip. Jackie's making the flip. Alrighty, here we go. We are going to put these beautiful flankers on.
Yes, look at that.
What he doesn't know is that he's not going to be able to clean this grill ever again. He's going to have to sandblast it off.
And he might as well throw this grill away.
And the idea is to keep basting. Make sure you cover the steak real well. And can you smell the sesame? How does Jackie smell? Let's go smell Jackie's steak. Smells burnt to me.
The most important job here is making sure people have things to eat on and eat with. You know, the food is kind of secondary.
Well, the food is about to be served, and check out this information on stinging insects.
Did you know that 500,000 people per year are brought to emergency rooms for stings alone? To avoid being one of these people, don't wear any bright colors, and don't make any sudden hand movements or body gestures that really pisses them off for some reason. In wall voids, under beams, in attics, in basements, in crawl spaces, and even under porches. Honeybees in an actual ceiling that it got so wet from the honey that the ceiling started sagging. It got so wet that when I stuck my injector up to kill the bees to do a little fog, half the ceiling came down. I had to bring a customer to the hospital one time. He called me up for yellow jackets. I get to his house and he's got a hose and he's fighting off the bees like he was fighting a fire, all right? The bees fly by, sting him in the neck, and I had to take him to the hospital and waste 3 hours in the emergency room. Well, bee stings can definitely kill you. I mean, I've seen guys that had to be really taken off a job, or kids in a school. You know, they got stung. These kids, they don't know they're allergic until you get stung. You know, and they don't have any EpiPens or anything, so either you give them Benadryl, you know, and I wouldn't even fuck with that. I'd just get to the fucking hospital. Yeah. I don't want to start giving medical advice. Because anything happens, they're allergic to Benadryl. Well, he didn't say if you're allergic to Benadryl. What the right. Fuck? Yeah. Now you're suing the ex-exterminator. Yeah. No, I've never had a fear of anything as far as pest or bee stings related. Actually, I went in a lot of times without any protection just to do the actual treatment. I would stick my hand in a hedge and very gently remove a wasp nest and bring it out and then kill it and save the nest with a powder, usually a dust. We blow it into the main entrance of the nest. It's usually a silica gel powder. Never attack anything during the day, okay? Everything is to be attacked at night when all the insects, the bees, the wasps, are back in their nest. And what I suggest is that you spray the outside of the nest down with a wasp freeze first. That will actually freeze any wasps and put a coating on the nest, and then take your powder, inject the bellows, and bellow some dust up into the nest. What the fuck? Unbelievable. I can't work under these conditions.
We'll be here until the 25th to wait for your steak to be ready.
Fundraiser.
Would you like some meat?
Would I?
Yeah.
Come on, man. This is amazing. Thank you so much.
Yes. There's $20 in it if you say that mine is best.
It's very simple. Larry cooked the steak. I cooked the steak. This is okay, much
better. There it is. Mine's better. His sucks.
Truth of it is, shut up. His is great. He marinated. He did a great job. I put a cow on there, and I basically burned his feet and served the rest of it. We're eating it anyway.
That's good.
Love it.
Good.
I got to say, it's a delicious piece of meat, though. I really
she
look
is.
Look at
she
that.
She is. Really.
This portion of our show is brought to you by LMN Printing Company of New York, bringing you 45 years of digital printing, from business cards to posters, from graphics to website designs, plus a full line of advertising promotional materials. Located at 23 West Merrick Road, Valley Stream, New York, don't hesitate. Pick up the phone and call 516-285-8526 or go to lmnprinting.com for all of your printing, advertising, and promotional needs.
Toss me that like that.
Oh, I think I got it. So how many balls do you get?
Two.
Just two balls?
Oh, I'm the thing meant in life.
Okay. Okay.
If you hit the green, you get a point. If you hit it into the big hole, you never call her back.
You get the clap.
You get three. If you get in a little hole, you get five. This is Bill, the scorekeeper.
Bill's going to keep score.
Up first will be Larry Rizzo.
All right.
The big hole is Roseanne. The little hole is Natalie Wood.
All right. First one's in the big hole.
You got three.
I got 3 points. Let's have a little excitement from the audience. Thank you very much. Oh, he's trying to.
I'm stuck.
Oh.
That's okay. I think he's still
zero. Zero.
Oh, okay. That's not good. I hit the green, though, didn't
I? No, you hit the white.
Okay. Oh! What's he get?
I am Molo.
How many points? How many points are that?
Five.
Oh, it's 5 points.
That's one.
I hit the green.
Do you know that joke? That's one?
No.
The farmer picks up his mail order bride at the post office, and on the way back in the horse and wagon, the horse stops to graze. And he says, "That's one horse." He kicks the horse to get him going again. Then the horse stops to graze again. He says, "That's two horse." He kicks the horse to get him going again. The horse stops to graze again. The farmer takes a shotgun and blows the horse's head off. And his new mail order bride says, "Wasn't that a little extreme?" He says, "That's one wife."
Oh.
We played this game.
Walking away just confused me.
10-3.
Ha! That's minus one.
That's a mulligan.
That's called a dick out.
That's called a mulligan.
Don't you get do-over?
Yeah, it's a Hindu.
Man, come on.
It's a Hindu. Continuation, my box.
This is a cute little game.
One. That was a one.
I don't feel on my game.
Did you know that Stevie Wonder challenged Tiger Woods to a golf match?
Yeah.
And Tiger Woods said, "Come on. You got to be kidding." Stevie said, "No, good golfer. I have my friend stand there by the hole, and he whistles, and I aim at that." Tiger Woods says, "All right, Stevie, I'll play golf again." Stevie says, "Well, let's play for a lot of money, make it interesting." Tiger Woods says, "All right, name the time and the place." And Stevie Wonder says, "How about tonight?"
That's adorable.
Let's get another 5 points.
Whoa! Oh! Oh!
If I get a laugh, I am on fucking fire.
Ever hear the Gilbert Gottfried?
That may. Oh!
I'm used
that
to the big holes.
The first joke in the history of man, but I think Bill Porcelli's about to tell a joke.
No, I don't. I can't tell jokes. I was just curious if you knew it.
You're wondering if I know it. The mother comes down and says to the daughter, "What do you want for breakfast?" She says, "I guess I'll have some of those shitty cornflakes." So the father gets up and beats the hell out of the daughter. And the mother says to Johnny, "What do you want for breakfast?" He says, "I sure don't want any of those fucking cornflakes."
Is that the joke?
That's basically it.
Yes,
it's a Joy Behar, actually.
Ah! One.
You got one.
You should
one.
Tell your joke. Jackie, he has a joke.
A horse walks into the bar. The bartender says, "Why long face?" The horse says, "I've ate." That's not
that.
That's it.
What?
Now, I'm going to tell you a secret. I wrote that.
You did?
Which one?
A long time ago, I got this bright idea, like when we were starting a joke show, that I was going to do something where you add a line to a classic joke that's been around forever. Okay. And the oldest joke in the world is, a horse goes into a bar and the bartender says, "Why a long face?" So I added the line, "I have cancer." And he just, I mean, did you?
No, I heard it. I didn't make it up. I heard it somewhere.
But I mean, I'm sure somebody else could have come up with the same premise, but I've never heard anybody say it before. There were only two jokes I could make it happen with. Why the long face? I have cancer. But they got to be so old. The jokes have to be so old that everybody knows the joke is over.
Right.
And the other one was, Mrs. Johnson, can Johnny come out and play baseball with us?
Oh, yes.
And she says, "Hey, you know Johnny has no arms
legs.
And no legs." And they say, "That's all right, we're going to use him as third base." And his mother says, "Okay, I'll dress him in white." And that was the extra line.
A lady breaks down, her car breaks down in San Francisco. So she brings the car to the mechanic. And the mechanic says, "Listen, it's going to take me a while to figure it out. Why don't you go have lunch or whatever, you know?" So she goes down to the pier or whatever. She has lunch. She comes back and she goes, So what's wrong with my car? He says, you blew a seal. She goes, no, it's just a little mayo from lunch.
That's terrible.
I thought it was cute.
You know the big fat...
I'm golfing over here.
The big fat Polish lady, pushes her car into the... The big fat Polish lady pushed her car into the gas station. And she says to the mechanic, she says, it conked out. So he works on it a little while. And pretty soon the engine's purring like a kitten. And she said, what's the story? He said, crap in the carburetor. She says, how long I have to do that?
That's good. Oh, you got
same shit. What'd you get?
No, I got shit. No, I actually got one for hitting the green.
Is Bill's not keeping score?
Bill, you keeping score?
He is, yeah.
He is. He's on
top of it.
Oh,
I thought it was going to roll back down.
Anytime you start with money.
That's one, Bill.
It goes to hell.
Well, you got six. You
got
to play 10,
maybe.
Okay.
All right.
Oh.
Oh, you're a
whore. I'm going the slow way. I'm not getting the fives. I'm getting the threes. We were on a...
Oh, you guys kissing.
Do you know how people get to you, like, on a golf course or something? So we're golfing, and a friend of mine wore jeans on the golf course. And there's a couple of yuppies in back of them with the sweaters over their shoulders, and they're going... You're wearing jeans? He said, watch this. He says, I'm wearing jeans because I was in a fire. You want to see my rancid burnt legs? He wasn't injured.
He wasn't injured?
No.
He lied?
But he shut them guys
up. So you hang around with people that lie?
I do. I hang around with liar exterminators. That's what I do. They all lie.
Ah! I thought that.
I got one. I got one, Bill.
I thought that was a fiver.
That was a Hindu.
That's a smarty pig.
We had a backdrop.
You didn't say if there was any off the wall.
The backdrop is there for you too.
Off
no,
the
nuts.
Wall.
That's eight. You
want
to go to 10?
Two more.
Who does?
I knew there was a holiday coming up.
Oh, man.
Zero.
That really sucked.
Yeah, he's a
zero. That was a zero. This is a fun game.
It is. Should be done outside.
Yeah. But the
look at this right. Little chip. All right, how many you got now?
Three.
You're the Tiger Woods of comedy.
How many more do we have? One more.
One more.
I'm choking up.
Why? Somebody die?
Yep.
Oh, what was that?
It's the bottom of the ninth. I don't really have to come to bat.
No, you don't.
But I'm going to go out on a five.
That's
right.
Oh!
One.
All right, what's the score? Very good, Jackie.
Bravo.
Great game. You're an excellent golfer. And
thank you, Jackie. Thank you very much for being on the show. Thank you very much
you're
for hosting
welcome.
Us.
I love having you.
I love being here. What did you say?
I love having you.
Don't forget to check in at laughswithlarry.com. Go to our new webpage, Cooking with Comics, and see who our next comic guest will be.